I'm actually recording this one day before results are supposed to come out, and I decided to come out here just because inside is getting a little bit boring and I think it's a little bit more calm and peaceful outside. I realized I haven't introduced myself for like any new people who are just clicking onto this video. So hi, my name is Rohan. I'm a third year medic studying at Cambridge University. This year, for third year of medicine, we kind of take a year out. All my modules were in neuroscience. Those were the exams I sat just gone 2 weeks ago. I wanted to reflect on it kind of from a Christian perspective, because I do think that changes the way how I kind of view academic success, exam results, that type of thing. And yeah, for a long time, I put a lot of emphasis on exam results and exam success. I do feel that kind of comes from kind of the immigrant mentality. So I think any children of immigrants who have worked exceptionally hard to come to a new country, to establish a living, their parents emphasize the value of hard work. And that was definitely in the case for my upbringing. I'm so grateful for the life that we live because of the hard work, the years and years of hard work my parents have put in, and also their parents as well. In the past, I've really been obsessing about exam results, and perhaps too much so. I'm kind of cautious that exam results, exam success, is kind of, I don't want it to become an idol, and I think it has done in the past. And an idol basically means that you kind of place more importance to that above your relationship with God. And I think for me, personally, I feel that when we have had success in the past, when we've done well in exams, it kind of becomes addictive. And when you see the formula that hard work can lead to good results, it really kind of makes you want to strive to do that again and again. And I'd actually say most of the pressure around exam results actually comes from me and not anything what my parents say or any like expectations that Cambridge put on us. Over the course of this year in particular, I've been reflecting on how I should be approaching exams and where does this fit in my priorities as a Christian. Because personally, on the one hand, I do think it is important to care about exam results. Even tomorrow, if I fail, I will be disappointed. And even if I get, let's say, like a lower mark than I'm expecting, although I know it's not the end of the world, it will be disappointing. This disappointment and also kind of just striving for a goal is necessary, because only if you kind of are wired in that way, you can be motivated enough to take the remedial action to improve the next time. And as a Christian, I do think that God has placed me here as a student in Cambridge to work hard and to do my best in whatever exams or trials which come up. In that way, I do want to glorify God in the way I work and in the way I approach exams. But I've come to realize that it's really important to have a balanced perspective. And I need to realize that satisfaction cannot come just from exam results. And as a Christian, our self-worth and our peace and joy should come from our relationship in God. Because exam results, they're fleeting. Like, yes, you have this huge moment of joy if you do well in an exam, if you gain a place at university, like, I don't know, when I got the results that I could come to Cambridge. But there's always another trial, another exam to go after that. So you can never rest in peace when you finish an exam, because you know the next challenge is just there on the horizon. So I think that's a suboptimal way of basing your happiness. And instead, the only peace and joy which like truly lasts, I believe, is Jesus' victory on the cross, like him defeating sin, saving us from the devil and bringing us into relationship with him. And defeating death, that is the only kind of lasting source of peace. Jesus himself says in Matthew to come to him, those who are weary and heavy laden, and he will give us rest. And yeah, there are so many verses which are kind of challenging the way I view my relationship with God, and basically are kind of convicting me that I need to find more satisfaction in just enjoy being with God, rather than thinking, oh, if I get this exam result, then I'll be happy. And so on. Versus like, I think in Psalm 27, it says that we are to gaze upon the beauty of God. Even like in 2 Corinthians, it says that my grace is sufficient for you. And I really want that to be more true in my life. I really want that to be that, yes, because of what Jesus has done, like, I'm so happy. I am overflowing with peace and joy. But so often, like, it's so easy just to be fixated on like the end result of like exams. I do think I've been better at finding that balance this year. So like last year, I pretty much went all out, like every day, kind of studying all day, pretty much. I feel that this year, yes, I know Maybe the first two terms I could have worked harder, but you know, I don't actually regret my choice because in my evenings I was able to spend more time with doing like Christian and church activities. I was able to go on many Christian camps as well. And I really do feel I was able to develop friendships, and also just this year has really been a year of spiritual growth for me. I did balance that by this term, I did work quite hard in the run-up to exams. But yeah, the balance is so hard to get right. And yeah, it's just something I need to keep praying about and hoping that the Holy Spirit will lead me in the right direction in this area. I also want to talk about issues around like the prosperity gospel and how Satan kind of uses that to turn our focus away from God and towards kind of our own desires. So the prosperity gospel basically refers to this idea that if you believe in God, then if you like pray and ask for certain things, that God will give you that. So God will grant you like successes and blessings in this world. This is often based on like certain verses which can be taken out of context. For example, I think Jeremiah 29 verse 11. Yeah, I got it here. Jeremiah 29 verse 11. For I know the plans that I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you and not to harm you. Plans to give you a hope and a future. A similar verse which kind of seems to promise all like these nice things will happen to us is Romans 8:28, where it says, in all things God works for the good for those who love him. So these verses do have a point to an extent. Good things do come from God. Like, God gives us the energy, and when good things happen, we should praise God. And which is why in previous videos, I don't hesitate to say that it was because of God that I was able to do something. And even in the case of exam results, if you kind of take a step back, there's so much more to what determines your result than just your own hard work. And it's only because of God's blessings that, for example, I have good health to go and sit the exams, that I have like a stable family life, and that's not causing like a distraction. And there's just so many things which can get in the way of us when we're doing exams, and in that it really is a blessing to like be able to sit the exams normally and to work hard for them. So that is always something to be thankful for. However, these verses can be taken out of context. And as I said, they may imply, if you just look at it in isolation, that God is just this father who will give you every blessing. But this is not necessarily true. So the verse in Jeremiah 29, it's actually part of a letter which the prophet Jeremiah wrote to the Israelites when they were in exile in Babylon. So this verse is particularly a promise for those who are facing extreme persecution. So it's unclear to what extent can we link this to our own kind of much smaller trials in exams when you compare it to this whole nation being subjected to exile. And then in Romans 8, the Apostle Paul is actually writing about how the Holy Spirit changes our life and how living by the Spirit helps us be free from sin. And in particular, verse 28 talks about how God works together in all things. So this means we can't just isolate kind of our own desires, like doing well in exams, as an example where God works for good. God also works for good in sufferings. So for example, when we fail an exam or when something goes terribly wrong. And this is actually reassuring, because even when things do go terribly wrong or unexpected, God actually has this master plan for us, which means we don't need to worry even when things seem to be out of control. We can know that God is in control. And that's something I need to keep reminding myself, that even if things don't go the way I planned or wanted to, that God has something better in store for us. And another problem with the prosperity gospel is there are some verses which seem to like contradict it directly. So I think in 1 Timothy 3, it suggests that those who are following God will face persecution. So that's something to bear in mind, particularly when we're approaching exams.